Hey, Swift here, and welcome to Vulpinology Part 7. Have you guys seen that cool picture of that pink fox online? You know, after I saw it, I thought about dyeing my fur a different color, but I don't think so. I think what really surprised me about that picture is that a lot of people think that she is some new, rare species of fox. In reality, she's actually a red fox like me. So how is that possible? Well, remember back in episode 4, I mentioned that red foxes can come in a lot of different colors? That's because of something called a fur mutation. Now, the genes responsible for your fur can get changed and tweaked a little bit. And a gene is something in your body that's passed down from generation to generation, and is responsible for things like eye color, hair color, or even how your fingers kind of line up. Now, that said, lots of different colors can show up on the red fox in nature, but flashy colors like that pink fox are the results of humans intentionally crossbreeding foxes to get a desired color. That was originally done for the fur trade, and sometimes that process can take up to hundreds of years to perfect. In recent years, however, fur colors like that are used mainly for domestication. You know, foxes as pets. I don't know if I would make a very good pet, but, you know. Anyway, more information about the fur mutations and the hundreds of different colors to come soon on our blog. And in the meantime, keep your eyes out for Vulpinology Part 8. I'm tongue-tied today. Woo! It's hot.